As long as she doesn't, I'm fine. I don't have a cold, I don't have a flu. She reaches across and she puts my sweaty hand, she puts her hand on my sweaty hand and she goes, I wouldn't do that to you. So, the brave guy said, as long as it's not smallpox. And in true non-Indian fashion, my hand just looks at me and she goes, that's funny. Indian humor, Indian stand-up. And so, you know, the ice is broken there. And, you know, we sat there for 2 hours. So, didn't know what was going to happen. And here I make a cut, you know, and got to talk about, you know, what's going on in Indian country. And I'm going to take this from this level of this laughter, this medicine of laughter, and share that. You know, again, these kids open their heart, and these people got to see what these kids live every day. You all got to see the special, whoever got to see the special, and whoever didn't get to see the special, ABC.com, Hidden America, you can watch this entirety online. But these kids brought something out that started the moment that thing was played. It empowered all of Native youth. And I see these kids out here dancing and practicing their culture. That is one thing we as Native people need to push. And what's awesome about it is the kids are gravitating towards it. The kids themselves these days are saying, I want the songs. Teach me the songs. Teach me the ceremonies. Teach me the prayers. And they're gravitating towards it. And they're getting their identity. You know, when I was, you know, I grew up traditional. I grew up in ceremonies and Hombletcha when I was 14 years old, and Sundance when I got out of the Marine Corps. And I was always a part of those ceremonies. That was just a part of my life. But when I got back from the Marine Corps and started going home to these ceremonies, I started to notice this renaissance of the kids singing the songs, beating at the drum, and praying. And I'm seeing something today that we're capturing something. That's our identity. You know, when I was Robert's age, the cool thing was gangster rap. I mean, anybody who's in their mid-30s like me remembers Ice Cube and NWA, and we all wore the hats, and, you know, we picked up a lot of that. A lot of my friends, we all, you know, picked up this L.A. lifestyle, but it wasn't us. But today, these youth are picking up the chanupa, the pipe, the songs. They're wearing shirts and things and dancing and taking us up to that next level. And as adults, I'm very proud to say that I'm happy to be a role model to these two, to Louise, to Tashina, and anybody else out there. I'm happy to be a role model.